Thanks. Kevin Pitsnoglen and Will Sheridan jump it up. Mike Kitts throws the ball up. He's working with Fran Connolly and Frank Scagliato.
As usual, Villanova right out man-to-man, trying to be very aggressive on the defensive end early against West Virginia.
Kyle Lowry getting one of the big assignments on Mike Gansey. Pitsnoglen is being defended by Sheridan. Frank Young to Gansey. Left side Collins, he rarely shoots, and a hold is called on Allen Ray. Jay Wright is in his fifth season as the coach of the Wildcats. Took them to the Sweet 16 a year ago, where they lost to the eventual national champion, North Carolina Tar Heels. Working the officials already.
Doesn't take long, does it?
24 seconds in. Inbound to Gansey. Throws on the run, and the rebound is ripped down by Kyle Lowry. Part of this four-guard Villanova contingent. Look at that. Quick ball movement on the perimeter. That's Ray's 37th three-pointer of the year. He leads the Big East in that category, and already the full-court pressure.
Changing up on defense for Villanova after a make, going to the full-court pressure, wanting to increase the tempo of this game.
Pitsnoglen for three, no good. Rebound battle off the backboard by Foy inadvertently. Couldn't get the second hand on the ball. And a reset for the Mountaineers. They are 9-3. They won their Big East opener Thursday at South Florida. Didn't play particularly well. They won 57-53. Frank Young shoots over Foy and hits the tough shot with a hand in his face.
And what West Virginia is looking for today is a third score. Someone to step up with Pitsnoglen and Gansey and give them that guy to take some of the pressure off of their leading two.
Occasionally it's Air Bear. He had 21 points against Oklahoma. Young steps into the passing lane and comes away with the steal. Mountaineers second in the Big East in that category, and Air Bear takes it right to the rim.
One of the few times you'll see Villanova fall asleep at the switch in transition defense. No one guarding Air Bear, able to get right to the basket and convert.
Jay Wright was telling me on Friday night, he says, that's my greatest concern as they get back. They get up and down the court so quickly, it seems like they get a layup. And here we go, Gansey ahead of everyone, but the pass was misfired. Here's Nardi. He'll wait to reset the offense, guarded by the taller Air Bear. Air Bear 5 inches taller. Lowry drop step, tough shot, and the foul.
Already seen both.
56% shooter from the floor, and off the miss, it comes to Ray for three. Wow, there's a good trade-off.
Exactly why you can't give Villanova extra opportunities on the offensive end. You ended up trading what would have been one additional point. It ended up becoming three.
Ray, third in career threes at Villanova. That was his 243rd. Pass deflected off the hands of Air Bear. Collins starts to go, and then we'll bring it up top. On the switch, being guarded by the much taller but slower Sheridan. Let's see if he tries to beat him off the bounce. Used his quickness to get the shot off. Gansey's all over the place, isn't he?
That was good defense by Sheridan, not allowing Collins to get to the basket against him, forcing a jumper.
And on the drive, it's Collins again. He goes right by Sheridan.
But one for two isn't bad for Will Sheridan. Twice in the matchup against the quicker guard. Won the first one.
Right.
But on the rebound, the offensive rebound, creating the extra opportunity, did not win the second one.
Here's the 1-3-1 West Virginia zone we told you about. And cross court, it results in the turnover. 2-on-1, Young with Gansey. Looks for the trailer, Pitsnoglen. Rebound in the lane and over the back foul on Young, and that'll be his second. And one thing West Virginia is not, Charles, they are not deep.
Can't afford to go into the bench. They need their guys to stay on the floor. Don't have the depth to combat what Villanova can throw at them because of the interchangeability of the four guards.
And John Beilein has to get Young out of there, and he inserts his son Patrick, who in Thursday's game at South Florida became the all-time record holder at West Virginia with 201 career three-point field goals. Nardi to Foy for three. Rebound pulled down by Air Bear. It was a good rebounding guard at 6'6". Pitsnoglen puts it on the floor with the left hand. Jason Frazier is checked in for the Wildcats. Villanova with that four-guard contingent, and the four combined, Charles, for 77% of the Wildcats' points.
And add on to that, they actually rebound a little bit too. When you add up the rebounding totals, almost 16 rebounds per game from the four guards. So when you hear four guards, you think, boy, they must be a weak rebounding team. Not the case with Villanova.
A And on the drive, we're going to get a blocking foul.
Get the final status on his knee and whether he might make it back for the stretch run this season. He wants to come back and play with his classmates, but we'll find out more after tomorrow's examination.
Tore his ACL the first time, March 20th. Tore it again in the preseason, October 19th. Look at the feed, Gansey to Airbear. That's the way to beat full court pressure.
What you have to love about that is that West Virginia attacked the pressure. Didn't throw it across half court and then bring it back out to start offense again. You have to attack it and try to score.
Lowry, Gansey plays out front on that 1-3-1, and Collins plays the back line. All 5'11 of them. Down low to Frazier, and Collins is going to be called for his second foul. And what
per ball game.
Out of the timeout, checking into the game for the first time for Villanova, for West Virginia rather. We're getting a look at Darris Nichols, number 14, as Collins had to leave with his second foul. Young also on the bench with two fouls. Lowry slips and falls. Pitsnagel gets his big mitts on it. And here come the Mountaineers, who have outscored Villanova off the break. 4-0 in the early going. Someone's got to find number 34. Well, Frazier did eventually, didn't he?
Wow. Great recovery by Jason Frazier. I thought that was going to be an easy deuce for Kevin Pitsnagel. He had beaten the other bigs down the court. But Frazier comes from behind and swats it away. And Pitsnagel looks at the official in disbelief, saying, no foul? Had to be a foul.
Last time Pitsnagel will waste a ball fake on a 6'1 guy, Nardi, huh? He'll get it up there.
Not often you see Pitsnagel in the painted area like that, too.
Gansey with lightning fast reflexes to catch and fire from 3-point range. The transfer from St. Bonaventure. In his very first year in a West Virginia uniform, the Mountaineers came within a whisker of going to the Final Four a year ago. Lowry to Nardi for three. Villanova 3 of 4 from behind the arc.
Right back to the pressure. 1-2-2 zone press.
Keep in mind the point guard Collins is on the bench. There's a reach-in foul. 3-point accuracy.
Another example right there, and that's from well behind the established line, showing his range.
Nichols to Gansey, to the cutter, beeline.
And that's something West Virginia has to do, Bob. They've got to make sure that they get their back cuts and drive the ball towards the basket, because otherwise all Villanova will do is just guard the three-point line and make it tough on their outside shooters.
There isn't a team in the country that's better at executing back cuts than West Virginia, as their opponents in the NCAA tournament learned the hard way last March. Foy with a tough shot off the glass.
The ability to not just shoot the three ball, but to take it to the basket and use their bodies, because they're so strong. Talk about the guards for Villanova. With no fear going inside, that allows them to expand their games.
On the right, Airbear starts to go. Foy with quick hands. Knocks the ball. Gansey winning it with a couple of free throws with 2 seconds left. And once again, executing the cuts. Gansey cut for the hole without the ball, and they found him.
That's going to drive Jay Wright crazy, because they spent a lot of time in practice, obviously working against those types of cuts and options in the West Virginia offense.
How's this? 7 field goals, 6 assists for the Mountaineer. But Nardi buries the three with a hand in his face.
These are not uncontested shots. You know, for the most part, West Virginia's trying to get out and close out on the shooters. A 20-second timeout.
From wire to wire in that one, but they've virtually led from wire to wire in every game all year.
367 of a possible 400 minutes this year of playing time, they've been in the lead.
Patrick Beilein looking for his 200-second career three. Won't get it, but Nardi lost the rebound out of bounds.
And I know that Coach Beilein would love to see his son start to heat up a little bit as we look at Jay Wright barking instructions from the Villanova sidelines. Patrick Beilein's an excellent three-point shooter, but he's about 6 or 7 percentage points below his normal three-point shooting.
For his career, he's 36%. On the drive, Nichols with the tough shot, and he gets the rebound between the 6'9 Frazier and the 6'7 Cunningham, who then catches up and blocks the shot. And the ball will belong to Villanova. Last touch by, actually his last touch by Fran Connolly's midsection.
After Patrick Beilein tried to punch it out. Now that shot didn't go down, But two things John Beilein has to like about that last possession. One, they created an extra opportunity with an offensive rebound. And two, Patrick Beilein drove it at the basket. That should create more space for the shooters later.
Pitsnoggle with the block, and here comes Beilein. Villanova does a good job of getting back quickly on defense. Nichols on the switch, being guarded by the 6'9 Frazier. To the cutter, Air Bear sets up Pitsnoggle for three. That was sort of vintage West Virginia basketball.
Perfect.
Cut and kick.
Perfect. Great call, Bob, because exactly what happened. Drove it to the basket, drew the defense, able to kick it out. That opened it up for the shooter behind the line.
And Ray loses the ball out of bounds. Turnover number 5 for the Wildcats. Jay Wright was telling me, Charles, that when it comes to defending this West Virginia team, he says, your instinct when you start playing basketball as a little kid is you defend the basket close to the goal. So when someone drives down the lane, instinctively you gravitate to the ball. Then they kick it out to so many guys that can hit the open three, and it's really very, very difficult to defend.
Break all the rules in defending them. Another nice drive by Patrick Beilein. He knows what the scouting report is on him, and that's to guard him at the three-point line. And early in the game, he did what you just described. Broke the rules again. Took it into the basket, opposite what he normally does.
Shane Clark, freshman number 35, is checked in for Villanova. Just became eligible at the conclusion of the first semester. Only his third game. He's from Philadelphia, went to high school with Kyle Lowry. Nardi already has a couple of threes on the drive. Looked like he took at least one step too many. That's turnover number 6 for the ball. You don't play for John Beilein if you can. That's for sure.
You won't be out there very long, will you?
Out of the timeout, a first look at Alex Ruoff, freshman from Spring Hill, Florida, number 22. Remember, West Virginia playing with two starters on the bench. Frank Young, J.D. Collins, each picked up 2 fouls early. Now, Ruoff tried to feed to the backdoor cutter, Air Bear, and went out of bounds. Turnover number 3 for the Mountaineers.
What I liked was the recognition of Randy Foy, understanding this is a freshman coming into the game, not normally a ball handler, and attacking him on defense and forcing the turnover.
Let's see how that freshman Ruoff now does at the front end of that 1-3-1 zone. Clark left his feet without knowing what he wanted to do. Cardinal sin. Beilein to Pitsnoggle. Ruoff. Nichols on the dribble drive is bumped. No, he stepped on the end line. Turnover number 4 and the 2nd in a row for the Mountaineers.
Well, the good thing for the freshman Ruoff is that after he turned it over, he came right back and created a turnover. So that helps it helps a young man coming into the game. Your first move is a mistake, but he bounced right back with a positive play.
Turnover story, and these two teams take care of the ball so well. West Virginia number 1 in the Big East, 2 in the country in turnover margin. Villanova 3rd in the Big East in turnover margin. Great look inside, but Clark dribbled the ball away from the basket. Down low, Clark again. This time his turnaround jumper. Jay Wright is very high on Clark. He says it's going to be tough to find the minutes on this team, but we have to do it because he's a guy that has guard skills but has tremendous size. The double team down low. Now Pitsnoggle for the moment being guarded by Foy. Foy is 7 inches shorter. Beilein, that's the 3rd time he's driven to the hoop. The 1st time he came away empty. The other end, Lowry. He doesn't come up empty.
The difference in the drive, the strength of Lowry powering it to the basket. Even against defensive pressure, Patrick Beilein bumped off the ball as he drove to the hoop.
Capacity crowd here at the pavilion getting into it. Cross court pass, Lowry deflected it out of bounds and nearly came up with his team leading 20th steal.
An old adage of basketball, Bob, the best defender on the floor is the last person who made a basket. Who just scored for Villanova? Al Lowry.
Kissing it off the glass at the other end.
Excuse me, Kyle Lowry. And he kissed off the glass and came back and then knocked it away on the defensive end. Once you score, you're juiced up to get the ball again.
Jay Wright wants to know why isn't Lowry at the line at the other end. He should have thought it should have been a basket and a foul. Here's Beilein, goes around the screen. Collins back in the game with 2 fouls. So J. John Beilein taking a gamble with 9:20 to go in the half. Didn't like the way his team was handling the ball without him. Cutting to the hole is Summers, the transfer from Penn State, and that's a third turnover for West Virginia in the last four possessions. Villanova with 20 of its 22 points from the backcourt. That's even above the 77% norm.
A little bit of a gamble by John Beilein with a few of the guys on the floor right now. Villanova going to try and take advantage.
Nardi is now 3 for 3 from three-point range.
Ball handlers for West Virginia. That's the tough part for them right now. They've got to get into some offense and get a good look.
Well, there's their offense. Gansey or Pitsnoggle throwing up a three. It's like a layup for anyone else.
When in doubt, right? Find number 20 in blue or find number 34 in blue.
Gansey is 10th in the country in three-point shooting percentage, knocking down 49.2%, and he's 2 for 2 today, has already scored 8 points. Two-point Villanova lead. Lob pass and nobody home but Airbear. And a silly bump in the backcourt by Lowry. His first for 26.
That's an LSU team that took Connecticut to the wire just yesterday.
Huskies winning it by one. Airbear for three. Rebound in the lane, pulled down by Sheridan, and he is fouled by Summers.
So he's ready to go down the stretch. But Pitsnoggle's in the best shape of his life. 10th in the Big East in minutes played in this young season.
Ray. Working on Beilein at that end of the 1-3-1 zone. Gansey back at the point of the zone with Ruoff back on the bench. Lowry penetrates and kicks to Clark for the contested three. Villanova from three-point range is 6 of 7. 10 of 12 from the floor overall. Gansey splits the defense. Sheridan called for the block.
See, what they want you to do is pick up your dribble early and start your offense way out high. Kyle Lowry didn't let that happen. Resulted in a nice three for Villanova.
Nardi's in shooting range, one step out of the locker room. All three of his threes have been from way behind the arc. Nichols kick out Beilein for three. His first of the day and his school record 202nd.
And they are sure looking for him to get off the schneid a little bit in terms of percentage. They know he can shoot it. They want him to shoot it like he's done in the good old days of last year. 36% in his career.
Clark starts to penetrate, loses the handle. Who touched it last? Nichols went down hard. It will be West Virginia ball. Last touch by Clark. Frazier back in for Villanova. Frazier coming off a spectacular effort off the bench at Louisville the other night. Tied his season high with 13 points. Had a season high 10 rebounds. And Jay Wright says it is just so rewarding for us to see that. Frazier has undergone 7 surgeries in a 2.5-year period. 5 on his knees, 2 on his hand. And he's finally healthy. He's finally able to go through an entire practice every day. It's the first time in his career at Villanova that you can say that. Beilein stops and turns, misses badly, and the rebound is pulled down by Ray.
Every time Patrick Beilein gets into the lane, it becomes a tough shot for him, but it's not very tough for Allen Ray.
Allen Ray playing a little game with Nardi of anything you can do, I can do better. They're both 3 for 3 for three-point range. And an over and back called on Pitsnoggle. 6th turnover on the Mountaineers.
They don't turn it over very often, but the pressure of Villanova forces you to speed up a little bit. And sometimes you go faster than you want to go. As we look at number 35, Shane Clark, checking back into the game for Dante Cunningham.
Clark originally signed to go at Maryland, changed his mind.
Yeah, he kind of went back and forth, didn't he? Right. Verbal to Villanova, yep. Signed with Maryland. Wasn't admitted there, ended up coming back to Villanova.
Of course, this is a senior-laden team for Villanova, so there will be an opportunity for Clark to play all of the time next year. Rebound pulled down by Nichols. Jay Wright just trying to work Clark into the lineup where he can now. Left side, Gansey. Boy, if you look closely, it almost looks like he looks for his footprints. He's fired all three threes from the same area.
Have a nice little chalk or taped outline on that spot. Says like, Mike Gansey was here.
Yeah, like CSI. Except he's very much alive.
I think we can solve that crime a lot easier, can't we?
Gansey with 11 points on the drive. Ray lays it up. We make that Lowry lays it up and in with the left hand.
But just so strong with the basketball getting to the hoop. These interchangeable guards, no fear going to the basket, excellent body control, and they finish.
Pitsnagel all alone underneath, and Frazier did it again. For the second time, Frazier came from behind to reject Pitsnagel. 152nd career block for Frazier, sixth most in Wildcats history. Boyd drives, and as he goes, a hold will be called. A hurry. Off the inbound, four. And Frazier bats the rebound, Ryle, and Pitsnagel comes away with it.
Good rebound by Pitsnagel, nice and strong, just took it.
Mountaineers out, rebounding Villanova by one. Beeline misses the contested three. Frazier rebound, here's Ray. Nichols does a good job of getting out on him in a hurry. Now on the left, Foy for three. Rebound Pitsnagel, his second. Villanova 10-0 for the first time since the 1961-62 season. They've won 10 in a row for the first time since the 94-95 season. Beeline and Pitsnagel could not connect, and the seventh senior from Amityville, New York, who arrived here, Charles, with the much ballyhooed recruiting class of Ray and Sumter and Foy. Ray for three. He's four for four.
You mentioned a little while ago about breaking the rules when you had to guard West Virginia. Well, Villanova, you keep saying they can't possibly shoot it from that far out on the court. I don't need to go out that far, and they keep draining them.
Wildcats 8 for 11 from three-point range. Look at the crisp passing, results in an air bear miss, a Pitsnagel tip, and a Foy rebound. Villanova up 7 with the ball. And as Foy starts to go, a blocking foul will be called. This one will be on
what appears to be a very special season thus far.
Of course, the flip side would be if he decides not to come back, he could return next year and have an entire year of eligibility. Would probably be to his advantage in terms of his draftability by the NBA. But his buddies won't be here next year.
No,
they'll be gone.
But it would be to the advantage of Villanova to have a senior leader to build with a new ball club, essentially. So Jay Wright has to have mixed feelings about the whole thing. But his number one concern is Curtis Sumter's health. That's the bottom line for him.
Sumter, a preseason All-Big East performer when both taken before he injured it the second time. Beeline rejected by Frazier, who now scoots ahead to fifth on the all-time block shot list with his 153rd. Foy with the miss. Frazier might have gotten away with one over the back on that rebound attempt. Beeline wide open for three. You can't give him that shot. Air bear in traffic. Another block by Frazier is fourth. Nardi on the dribble drive, and Nichols now has two fouls along with Collins. It's great, Charles, to have balanced scoring. It's also great to have balanced fouling. And West Virginia's not doing a very good job at that with two fouls each on Collins, Young, and Nichols.
Like to spread them out amongst your team and not have to face making the types of decisions John Beeline and his staff have had to make in the first half. Villanova showing zone for the second time down court.
Mountaineers missed their last six shots. Pitsnagel, right side jumper. That's a three, a delayed call from Mike Kitt. So Pitsnagel with his second three of the day and his 32nd of the year. He's got 194 for his career, third most in Mountaineer history.
I think Jay Wright wanted to show some zone and try and change things up with West Virginia. I don't think he'll stay in it too long.
Nardi with another deep three. This is like Groundhog Day.
On both ends. If it's not him, it's Gansey for West Virginia going to the same spot.
Nardi and Ray are each 4 for 4 from three-point range.
They did just about everything right in that game, did USF under Robert McCollum. Held them to 6 for 24 from the three-point line, out-rebounded them by 20, and still lost in another backdoor cut.
And what a spectacular long pass off the dribble for Collins, right on the screws.
textbook bounce pass into the lane, hit a Barron stride.
12 assists on 13 field goals for West Virginia. That's remarkable, but so is Villanova's 9 for 12 three-point shooting. Ray, ball fake. Goes around Air Bear. Wild shot, actually, is the pass, I guess, to Frazier, who could not pull it in underneath. Turnover number 10 for Villanova. Coming up on the Nissan Halftime Report, we'll take a look around the Big East, the early season conference. Tell you about a surprising Pittsburgh team. Our Oppenheimer close-up look at Villanova coach Jay Wright and first half highlights. Foul's going to be called, I believe, on Nardi. That will be his second and number 5 on the Wildcats. Jay Wright's club is a perfect 5-0 at home. I asked him, are you going to change things up against West Virginia like most teams do? Because West Virginia plays the 1-3-1 and shoots all those threes. He said, well, our first plan is to play the way we're playing because we're playing so well. And if that doesn't work, then we'll come up with a plan B.
Let's hope we don't get to plan B. We like plan A awfully well.
Young for 3. Frank Young with his 17th three-pointer of the year, the junior from Tallahassee. About a 2-second differential, shot clock, game clock.
Well said. And what a leader for him, because even if he's not scoring, he can put numbers up. He does it so well. He doesn't score big, he'll give you double-digit rebounds instead.
So let's see what Jay Wright diagrammed in the huddle. They can't quite run the clock all the way down.
West Virginia going man-to-man now instead of their normal 1-3-1 zone.
D-line guarding Lowry. That could be a tough matchup for West Virginia. Lowry on the drive. Kicks the boy for a contested 3 at the buzzer.